So hi guys, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play American Truck Simulator. If you remember in the previous episode, we drove up this new road here. I believe we drove from Stockton. We drove up this road here, past San Rafael, past Ukiah. I don't know how to say it. We drove around Walbert there. Quick stop off there. We went around that little road there, then up to Eureka. Today I found a job going across to Carson City. Now I know this one's paying a lot better, however we have already driven that route and I'm getting pretty bored of doing that same old route there across the Golden Bridge and down the side, and we haven't done this road here. So with this journey we can go down here, which is a new road for us, then down here, which is also a new road for us. We haven't driven down that little bit, so I think that's going to get a bit of discovery done. We have got 65%, as you can see here. We haven't done that road, then it'll be this one going down here, down into Carson. Nice little journey, that one. That's, what is it, 443 miles. Arctic Escurim? I don't know. 20 tons. 13 grand, or 14 grand basically, $30 per mile is still not very bad, and it's from my container pack once again. So let's go for that. Right, so once again I've got the Piva weather mod installed. I just love this weather mod. None of you guys commented in the previous episode to say if you liked it or not, so please do say so in the comments. That'd be super helpful. But yeah, I forgot to tell you guys in the previous episode about my recent pre-orders for games. So, I just love that. Back in American Truck. It's been, I don't know, it's been about 5 days since I've driven in this game. So nice to get back in this. In fact, earlier today, I was recording two videos today. Earlier today I was recording the time-lapse with the Iveco Eurostar, I believe it's called, an older Iveco truck, and it's so refreshing to be in here. Okay, looks like we're at the Tesla dealer. Bit of an unusual place to pick this up, but okay. Those brakes are a bit sharp. Right, freight market. In fact, what's on the external? No, I think they don't pay very well on the external contracts. It's only when there's hardly only a few jobs around that they only when you pay good. But I just love the detail on these containers. Let's try not and run him over. Into reverse, reverse one. On, and look at that. So we have currently got 13,600 miles on the truck. We have got enough fuel for 470 miles. This, oh, let's put that up. It's going to take 443 miles, so I'm guessing we're going to have to fill up. We can fill up there if we need to. And then it's just basically a straight road. Nice. That on there. Let's go. Done everything, so see ya. So we turn right out of here. Can we actually go left and then that way around? Oh no, we haven't discovered this road anyway, so we may as well go this way. Okay, we're all clear, in the clear. Let's give this some revs. We go up to 30 miles an hour. It's just got so much drama, this truck. I mean, it was just slowly accelerating, then it's the noise of it, it's great. But yeah, back to the pre-orders. So I have pre-ordered two games. that are coming out soon, before Christmas. So the first one that I pre-ordered is Horizon 3, Forza Horizon 3. Now, there's two different versions, but the two main different versions are, there's a digital version, then there's just a standard Xbox version. The digital version, you get, is it called Microsoft Play Anywhere or Play something? Basically, it's a cross-platform thing, so you can play on the PC and on the Xbox. Now, you may be wondering, well, why would you want that? You wouldn't want two separate profiles. Well, what it does, it syncs. So say, oh, I fancy playing on the Xbox, let's do that for a bit. Say you play some Forza on the Xbox for a bit, then you think, oh, I want my racing wheel back. Don't know why you would, but I do hope they've got racing wheel support on PC, by the way. Say you move back to PC, then all your game save is synced, so you don't lose anything. So all the races that you won, all the cars that you've earned. Yes, that's the digital version. So if you want to play on Windows 10, you have to get the digital version. I've got to get a photo by the Mad River, right? Wonder why it's called the Mad River. Is that what it said? Not the Med River or something. Mad River. I'm not going mad. I honestly didn't mean to say that then. I was like, hey, joke. I bet that's a thumbnail. Doesn't look very mad to me. Just look at that skybox in the mirror. That is amazing. But yeah, back to Forza. Now, apart from the digital and the non-digital version, or the disc version, there are other different versions. There are a lot of different versions. I think there's the standard, there's the platinum or something, and then there's the ultimate. Now, I've gone for the ultimate edition. That means I get it 4 days early. So I get it on the 23rd of September, opposed to the 27th, where all the other versions come out. So I should be able to get your content a little bit early. I have got all the car packs. I've got the car pass. I've got the VIP car pass. Basically all the passes and stuff. I get a free car with game. If you live in the UK, I'm guessing you know what the game store is. On the high street and online. I pre-ordered it from game, and you get a free limited edition car with it, the Ferrari 488 GTB. So yeah, I got that with it as well. I think that's it. But the thing that was weird was that with the disc version, disc ultimate version, you get also a free 143 scale model Lamborghini Centenario. Now, I'd really like that. I do keep all the little limited edition game versions and stuff, with all the little cars and stuff that it comes with. I mean, Forza last year, I don't think I got the ultimate edition for Forza. I think I just got the game limited edition pack or something, and I got a free Forza 6, well, not free because I had to pay extra for it, but I got a Forza 6 t-shirt that still doesn't fit me, but wow, this road's cool. Let me get another t-shirt. I don't know. Right, let's get one from the front. We haven't got one from the front yet. Let's get like wide, maybe like that. Right, let's get one from the other side. Go around to back and then turn around. What's that say? Oh, cool. Oh, cool. I don't know. Well, that looks cool. That looks really good. Right, take a photo and keep on going. Keep on trucking. Right. But yeah. So I've got the Ultimate Edition of Forza in the digital edition, if you see what I mean. Hopefully you do. But it's probably the same everywhere else. When you pre-order a game, you have to put like a £5 deposit. And I think the full game, the Ultimate Edition that I got is around £80. Which is a lot, really, but I really do like the Forza games, and I do end up buying most of the DLC. So, if I'm going to buy most of the DLC, I may as well just get it all in the first place, because I know I'm going to love the game. I loved Horizon 2, I know I'm going to love it, I'm so excited for it, driving around Australia. I will do a Let's Play, as you know, but I'll get into that later in the video. I'm going to talk about my time. Did you see that? So it went from 55 down to 35. Bang, I get into the zone. Cop car behind me. I don't know. But look how realistic this looks. This weather mod is superb. Oh, that's so annoying. You saw that. That was so totally unfair. Oh, 25 here, better slow down before they give me another ticket. Oh, this is getting a bit twisty. I'm getting back in, I don't want to crash. But yeah, that's what I've done with Forza. Anything else I need to say? Oh yeah, with Forza 6, because it isn't really my Xbox, I share it with my brother. I don't know. I didn't really get to play it as much as I'd like to. I think I probably got about 40 hours in the game. I did quite a lot on it. I got quite far in the series, but I never completed it fully. Just annoying me. I got about maybe a 3/5 through the game. I don't know, but yeah, I did really like it. And yeah, carrying on, what other games have I pre-ordered? So the other game that I pre-ordered, you'll probably be able to guess it, but Gran Turismo Sport. I have pre-ordered Gran Turismo on the PS4. Obviously it's only on the PS4. Well, considering you're a cop car, I would have thought you'd think better, but no. Wait, doesn't like this hill. Got to rest soon, haven't we? 2 hours. What are we doing on fuel? 340. Okay. There's no like good forward photos today, they're all from the rear of the truck. It's kind of annoying. But yeah, I pre-ordered Gran Turismo Sport. Now, I only got the standard, well, only got the standard version for Gran Turismo. Games now, I mean, I remember the days when they used to be like £30 for a new game on like the console. Now it's 50. I don't know. But yeah, it's £50. For the full for the standard version, which is the one that I've got. Let's slow down before we get another ticket. And again, that's a £5 deposit. With game, yeah, I got it through game again, by the way. I don't think you get any special pre-order things with Gran Turismo. I could be wrong. But, I have to what the heck was that? That was the loan, I hope. I think so. I forgot what I was going to say. Oh dear. This keeps happening to me. I'm like thinking about something. Something happens. And then I can totally forget about it. I bet it happens to you as well. Then I'm thinking about it for ages. And then what happens It's about an hour to 2 hours before I go to bed when it's got no need anymore. I usually remember it. Oh yeah, I don't think there's anything with Gran Turismo Sport, the pre-order, but the usual is, so yeah, I don't know. But I'm not as excited about it as I am for Horizon 3, I think. I think it's partly because Gran Turismo comes out in November. We're only in August at the moment. It could be to do with that, but I don't know, it's just... I don't know, we'll see how we go. Obviously, I will be doing that on PS4, so I'm going to need to get my Elgato out again. That's been sitting in its box. It's right above me now on a shelf. It's been sitting there for... since I stopped doing Drive Club videos, which was in February. So it's been sitting on there for a while. Let's get it out. Lots of traffic here today in, where are we? In Reading. Barbershop. Number one. Number one! Get that. But yeah, Gran Turismo Sport is coming. So those are the two games that I pre-ordered. Horizon 3 and Gran Turismo Sport. So, yeah. And also Fernbus, as I keep going on about, it's coming out Friday. And then I don't think there's any other games that I'm going to buy. I don't think. Let's check my notes. Probably going to crash whilst doing it. No. Apart from any DLC that's going to come out, like Vive La France. Have to come to a complete stop. What's that bin there? It's like a rubbish bin or... Oh, clothes and shoes. Okay, I got it. Oh no, I should have rested. What a mistake. Not going to make that, are we? Maybe we are. No, we're not. I'm going to have to turn around. I don't know. Yeah, we're not going to make that. Turn around. That's because I was talking. What an idiot. But yeah, I've done it again. What on earth was I on about? But yeah, other than DLC that's going to come out, there's nothing really on the agenda. But yeah, to the timetable. So I've been working out my new recording, editing, uploading timetable. And what I've came up with is I'm going to do, until Gran Turismo comes out, I'm going to do two different weeks. So there's going to be a week one, and then it's going to be a week two, obviously. Now, they're very similar, these 2 weeks. However, there are some differences. So, I'll just go through it when I've reversed. I mean, look at the detail on that container. It's so good. Oh, he's passing out. He's passing out on me. So obviously on Monday will still be the time lapse. Tuesday will still be Forza. Look how barren it is. Is anything coming? Oops, I just scraped the front of my chrome bumper. Wednesday will be 80 at Let's Play American Truck Sim. Let's get back up to speed. Thursday will be Test Drive Thursday. Friday will be a Let's Play of Fernbus. This is when I go back to, well, this is going to be the aim when I go back to school. But yeah, it's probably not going to be, I'm probably not going to be able to keep to it. So I'll be very busy. These brakes are super sensitive. Saturday will still be Project Cars or Assetto Corsa. and Sunday will be Let's Play American Truck Simulator. And that's basically the same. So week one is the same as it is now. However, week two, the differences are that on Sunday, I will be doing Forza instead of Let's Play. And obviously that will be Forza Horizon 3, not the current Forza that we're playing. So don't get confused with that. Let's check in that we had enough time to rest then. Most traffic's a lot, isn't it? It's building up. But yeah, I do want to play Forza quite a lot, Horizon 3, after investing all that money in it. So, yeah. But on week one, it'd be one Forza a week. Week two, it'd be two Forza a week. I do want to keep this Let's Play going though, unless you want to see it. Would you guys prefer to just have it like week two all the time is two Forza Horizon every week, or would you like to have two Let's Play and two Forza switching around? Either way, you're still going to have a Let's Play or a Forza a week. Please don't get a tick. Oh, you stupid thing. You saw me then. I had so many fines this journey. So annoying. Speeding? No, I wasn't really speeding, I was slowing down. Going through a red light because I couldn't get my gears. Angry. Right. Let's rest up and I'll see you in the morning. 11:13 PM. Simulators is turning on his truck. Second, brake off. Let's go. Lights on. Right, let's get back on the road. Back on the road again. Look at that moon. Oh, that's rubbish. What a massive letdown on the moon. Everything's great about it apart from the moon. It's not even circular. It's been squished. Oh, that's rubbish. I'd rather not have it. Why would they do that? It's such a great weather mod, and then it ruins it. Wow, that wall is beautifully placed. Yeah, that is the plan. And then my plan for recording is I'm not going to record on a Sunday. I'm just not. That's going to be my day off from recording. But I will be editing on Sunday. So I just won't be recording, I'll just be editing. I'll give my voice a break. Because talking for like half an hour to 40 minutes each day. Especially on the daily videos that I've done in the holidays has been killing me. Honestly has. Yeah, but I will record two videos on Saturday. Obviously I'm not in school and I'm not at school on Saturday, so I can do that. But it is a tough year this year. Next year, this year. Depends on you watching. So I don't know. If I'm being realistic, I can see it being 2 to 4 videos a week again. If I'm honest. And then, I don't know what's going to happen after that. I'll probably have to work at a different schedule and play a different amount of games each week. But I don't know, I really need to plan my time super well this year. Because if I want to do YouTube and revision at the same time, and school and homework and all the other stuff that I do, I really need to get my timetable right. But yeah, I won't go through all my editing things, I'm guessing you don't really want to know that, but basically I'm having Sunday off for recording and then I'm having Friday off for editing. I hope that makes some sense. Then after Gran Turismo releases, the weeks are all going to change. So on, well not, well, the other 2 weeks aren't going to change, but on week three, I think I may change, well, on week one and two, I may oddly change, well, basically, as soon as Gran Turismo is released, I will be playing it a lot, and it will overwrite some episodes of Let's Play and Project Cars and stuff. That's what's going to happen when a new game comes out. I want to play it a lot. However, once it all settles down a bit, on week one and two, Gran Turismo may overwrite some Forza, some Project Cars, I don't know yet. But on the week three is only valid once Gran Turismo is released. It's going to be Monday time lapse, Tuesday Forza, Wednesday Gran Turismo, oh, laptop's gone off, Wednesday Gran Turismo Sport, Thursday Test Drive Thursday, Friday Fernbus, Saturday Gran Turismo, and Sunday Let's Play. And obviously I'll have Friday off and Sunday off. But that is my plan so far. But when looking at the amount of series that I've got on, and when Gran Turismo released, the amount of series that I want to do, it's about 8 series. And I've only got, well, obviously I only got 7 days a week. And that's the problem with gaming on YouTube. You want to play all of these games and record all these games, but you don't have a chance. You just don't have the time, right, Nevada? I love that sign. High speed limits. But yeah, you don't have time. I want to play all these games. I mean, the games list currently is Euro Truck, American Truck, Forza 6 Apex, / Horizon 3, Gran Turismo Sport, Fernbus, Project Cars, Assetto Corsa. So it's currently the games that I want to play. And I would like to know if you guys would like some random videos, right, where I just go on a random journey in Euro Truck, and just talk instead of it just being scheduled all the time. Would you prefer that, or would you like to have a proper rotor? Because I think I would prefer the rotor method. I don't think it's a lot easier for me to plan my time then. I don't know. But please do tell me if you'd like to see one of that. Super dark though, it's weather mod. I mean, if you turn the lights on, I mean, you can't see anything. That's the way it should be. Oh, cars come in. Well, oh, we're going on to some form of interstate here. And suddenly there's millions of cars. Look at that. I mean, I can't see the road on the other side, so that's a bit weird. All those lights coming the other way. But I like it. And not forgetting when Vive la France comes out, I will be doing sort of driving around, discovering and exploring France, or discovering France, I can't remember what it was going to be called. I will try and do that. I was hoping for it to be released, or the DLC to be released in the summer, but SCS have let me down there, so I don't know. I don't know when I'm going to do it. And that's if it's going to work now. I think this is Reno. Was it Las Vegas? No, it can't be Las Vegas. No, it's Reno. A casino town. Alright, what's that guy doing? Please don't move over. Wow, this is struggling to get up to speed. I think it's a 23-ton trailer. Yeah, no, 20-ton trailer. 375 brake horsepower it is, if you're wondering. And it doesn't like this. that. Cool, I'd love to see the skylines all lit up at night. Right, 80 mile an hour speed limit. I think that sign said that lane was coming in. Yep. Well, you really can't see much in front of you, can you? You have to be really on it to, in this game at night, try not to go off. Well, it's going to be an overtake. Come on, Kenny. Up the hill. Bet all the cars behind are getting a bit angry. But by now, when you're watching this... You guys, in a couple of hours, if you're watching this as soon as it goes live, you should be... a new scan you should be releasing. I think it's about 20 to 7 UK time on Scania's website or something. The new Scania is being released on a live stream. You have to sign up for... You have to sign up to watch it on Scania's website, but that's easy. It's free to do so. And you can watch the Scania being unveiled. So that's in a couple of hours. Exciting times. But it'll probably be at least 2 years until it's in Euro Truck. But I'm just saying a decent mod is probably going to be 6 months work. But yeah, I'm quite excited about that. To be honest, I'm not a huge fan of Scania trucks. I mean, they're really nice, but I don't know. It's not for me, massively. I'm really excited about driving the Range T around France though, when that finally releases. Which, I don't know how long it's going to be. Could be still quite a long time. How are we doing on fuel? 105 miles, 54. Just down here. Haven't got long to go. But yeah. Exciting times, along with the new iPhone and Apple Watch, and probably a new Mac is coming out as per usual. And there's someone on YouTube that I'm watching recently. His channel's called Lewis's Tech, so it's L-E-W-I-S. Apostrophe S Tech. Now he does, he's got about 50,000 subs. He's been growing rapidly, his channel. Like in the last, I started watching when he had about 30,000 subs, and that was about a month ago. And it's just grown amazingly. Basically, what he does is he does like scam bait videos. So all the technical scammers who are scamming people. For like tech support, saying, oh, there's something wrong with your computer. And they get all the old people to buy the support. Well, not only old people, to be honest, but they're the most vulnerable. He just, like, messing with them and framing them, basically. And he's really good with it. I'd recommend you go and check him out. But he lives in Birmingham, near where I live. Okay, used cars. Not great. Just okay. I say that all the time. Getting into this lane. Come on, change. Yes. The gear changes. Super fast. I don't think I've got this one on advanced gearbox. Thing is struggling to get up to speed. Still 5.7 miles to the gallon. It's broken, I think. We are in the red lights came on the fuel, which is not good, obviously. Not good. Lake Tahoe. Look at that. I'm gonna take a photo there. I mean, look at the lights going down there. Like, you see them above the trailer. That looks cool. Yeah, let's go. What, 13 degrees outside? Wow. It's about that in the UK currently. At night, at least. Wow. I think it's because we're in the desert. It gets really cold in the desert at night, I think. I've never seen it that low before in an American truck. Where are we? Looks like we're at some kind of, is that Sunshine Crops? I seem to remember. S Crops, over here. Put in front of this guy, I'm sure he won't mind. I'm not too sure what it actually is. Is it some kind of seed or chemical? I don't know. I mean, it's definitely not chemical because it's not an ADR trailer, is it? I don't know. Where are we going? Over there. I've never reversed it down there before. I don't often drop off here. I usually just pick up here. I think this may be the first time I dropped off here. Like, concentrate mode. I'm gonna shut up. Go. I got pretty close to that box there, as you probably saw. Legs down. Excellent, please. Yay. 13 grand. Come on. Yay. Level 13. Workhorse. Right, where shall we put it? All right, let's click continue. Okay, then. So we got quite a few in just in time. Obviously, we can still go for that now. I don't want to do any longer journeys, you see, because this is good for an episode. I can just about, it's going to be about a 50 minute episode to do that journey, but just about okay. If I go for longer, which I don't really need to because the map's not that big, but if I go longer, this would be like the max distance of journeys that you can do. I'd have to split it, and I don't like doing that too much. Come on, flammable. Flammable solid, toxic, corrosive, high value. I don't know, what should I go for? Very dangerous, corrosive, that looks a bit dangerous, isn't it? What's going to get us the most money, though? Might go for another hazardous, because they get us quite a bit. So, the question is, what do we want to go for? Toxic? Infectious? Corrosive substances? Might go for toxic. That'll probably get us a lot of money. I like that logo, though, like the white with the black skull and crossbones. Right, looks like we're done. Let's have a look at the map. 67%. We should go down here in the next episode. But we are going to need to fill up. Right, where haven't we been? So we've done those ones now. Done most of that. So Hornbrook, we need to do that. We haven't been up to Jackpot. There's some of these roads down here that we haven't done. And then it's just these. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seven more towns or cities or whatever you want to call them. left to discover. But there we go, that's another episode in the bag. So if you've enjoyed this video, please click that like, want to subscribe down below, and please also say if you like this PIVA weather mod or if you don't. I mean, this is what's the time now? So 4:27 a.m. The sun will be coming up soon, just over there. I think it's the lightest, and I just love this royal blue look to it. As I said in the previous episode, this looks great. And yeah, why also have I said it yet, please subscribe if you haven't already. Be much appreciated. Much appreciated. I don't know, I've been recording for, I don't know, about 40 minutes now. My voice is really hurting me. But yeah, thank you for watching if you got this far. That's really good of you. You have, you put up for me for the 45 minutes or whatever I'm recording for. And hopefully you've enjoyed my little Kenworth here. The W900. We've done for over 14,000 miles in it now. So it's not too bad. I do like this thing. But anyway, as I said, thank you for watching, and I hopefully will see you very soon. See you guys.